Radio Éphémère.
Éphémère Radio live from the European Conference on Harm Reduction in Basel. So yes, we managed to find our way from Lausanne all the way to Basel, each of us more extravagant than the rest.
Nous sommes arrivés à cette conférence où il y a du monde.
And we arrived at this conference where there are people, lots of specialists and some people that look a little sketchy, others that are more serious.
Un peu louche, d'autres un peu moins. On se demande pourquoi ce sont celles qui ont l'air le moins louche qui ont.
And we wonder why it's always the people who look less sketchy that get to speak, but this question is reoccurring, so we won't spend too much time on it.
Et avec toutes les personnes qui ont été d'accord de dans ce projet, elles ont été se disperser certaines.
And with all the people that are a part of this project, they spread out, come to listen to the more or less interesting conferences given by different people.
Ça allait de la police qui voulait bien qu'on consomme à la maison, mais alors sans déranger les autres.
It went from the police who were okay for us to use drugs, but at home, without bothering anyone, and with no more dealers. So give us the solution. But he didn't seem to have one. For the others, I'm waiting to get the results so that our incredible sound man can give us a summary.
Régisseur de choc puisse en faire un résumé. En attendant, j'ai le grand, grand plaisir de pouvoir vous faire entendre un.
While we wait, I have the immense pleasure of letting you listen to a summary of what is happening in Quebec by the association ACTOPCSID. Yes, I'm not joking. So it's the Québécois Association for the Health Promotion of Drug Users. And this presentation is given by a charming person named Mumu. So bend your ears, it's very interesting.
Bon, alors je vais expliquer un peu c'est quoi mon travail. Moi, je travaille à l'injecteur depuis.
So I'm going to explain how we work. I've been working for the injecteur for the last 2 years. We call my role a helping peer. The name of my job is Infoman because I inform people through the magazine.
En fait, il y a différents programmes de pair aidant.
And in fact, there are different programs of helping peers in Montreal. Every institution has different programs. Some have programs where people can work a few hours a week. Sometimes they're paid, sometimes they're volunteers. Basically, the goal of being a helping peer is to help people close to you by using your experience. So my work, I write for the magazine, I visit all the institutions in Montreal, I do art therapy workshops with drug users, we're on different committees about health issues or defending our rights. I take different classes. The public health services train me about sexually transmitted diseases, about everything that concerns drug use, which means that we learn to become pretty much the same as a professional. There are people that before me had this job and that have gone farther now, that have good jobs because of the experience that they got working with
ACTOPCSID.
And now it's even gotten to the point that we give classes. The class is called The Blender. It's a guide that we made about the different mixes of drugs and the risks that come with it. And now we train drug users on how to use drugs with the least amount of risks. Because of course people know they're not crazy, they know that there are risks and that it's not good for them. But they still take drugs, so we give them things so it's not as dangerous for their health. And we also give the class to professionals, because there are lots of really good professionals. There are lots of them that have never used drugs, and so for them, sometimes it's hard to understand the people or to answer questions about drug consumption because they don't know. And often they've had classes for that, but they've never seen it. They don't know really what it is. So we explain to them how a drug user thinks, what the situation is of living on the streets, sometimes about sex work, and how to work with someone depending on what drug was taken. We give them little hints, we even talk about our own experiences so that they will better understand the people that they work with.
Donc, c'est à peu près mon travail.
So that's basically my job.
Et voilà, j'espère que c'est présent.
And there you are. I hope that this presentation interested you all. It's important to remember that these people started their project in 2005, and when we see what they've been able to obtain and to set up, it's really motivating, and it gives us lots of hope and motivation. I hope you will all be with us.
Et de la motivation. J'espère que vous serez avec nous. Et voilà la ravissante Mindy qui vient tout de
suite. And here is the enchanting Mindy, who is all smiles, and she succeeded in getting an interview with Aline Keller from Infodrug, who is one of the organizers of the conference that we're participating in, and thanks to who we've been able to have a place in this conference. We thank her for that.
Nous avons pu avoir une place dans ce congrès, d'ailleurs, nous la remercions. Et je vous laisse écouter.
And I'll let you listen to what she has to say.
Oui, voilà, je suis de nouveau.
And here we are. I'm in the company of Aline Keller, and I would like to know, you gave a place to FMR Radio, and we thank you very much.
FMR, on vous remercie beaucoup.
Alors en fait, nous, on était très très contents de pouvoir accueillir une
radio. So we were very happy to be able to welcome a radio of consommateurs, as you call it.
C'est très important de
because for us, it's very important to give a voice to drug users. It's something that's done too rarely in Switzerland, that is done more in other places in Europe. That's why we see that at this European conference, there are lots of organizations of drug users that are present, which is very nice for us. And the idea was really to do an event that is in the center of town, because harm reduction happens in the center, and that's why we looked for a place to hold the conference here in the center of Basel, and also to give a voice to drug users in the middle of the conference, and that's why we placed FMR Radio in the middle of the conference hall.
Merci beaucoup. Oui, bonjour, ici Mindy pour la radio.
Hi, here's Mindy for FMR Radio. I'm with
Elliot Albert.
Enchanté, monsieur.
It's a pleasure to meet you. I have a question. What are you hoping to get out of this
conference? D'accueil.
Je suis directeur exécutif de réseau international.
I'm the executive director of the International Network of Drug Users.
Dis donc, ces sujets, c'est autour de notre vie.
And so these subjects are about our lives. About our rights.
C'est essentiel que
so it's essential that we're here to be a part of this conference because without us, there's no conference.
Il n'y a pas de colloque.
Exactly.
J'aimerais vous poser une question. Quelle est votre addiction?
I'd like to ask you a question. What is your addiction? Will you allow me to ask this question? Do you have one?
Ce serait mes enfants parce que
it would be my kids because honestly I don't smoke, I don't drink, so
ouais, ça doit être ma
it would be my family, but it's not really an addiction because it's normal.
Oui, tout à fait.
Of course, thank you.
Est-ce que vous avez une addiction?
So do you have an addiction? No. No.
D'accord.
Au tabac. Oui.
Yes, to tobacco.
Excusez?
Au tabac.
Ouais. D'accord. Ok. Merci.
Thank
bien.
You. Goodbye.
Well, I have to think a bit. Maybe a little bit chocolate, too much. No.
Mais écoutez, je vais pas vous embêter plus longtemps. Est-ce que je peux vous poser une question un peu pertinente?
So I don't want to take any more of your time. So can I just ask you a very pertinent question? Do you have an addiction?
Oui.
Oui, oui. Je fume le tabac, je bois de l'alcool, et je fume le cannabis.
Me? Yes, I smoke tobacco. I drink alcohol. I smoke cannabis. And I take cocaine, speed, amphetamines, and other psychedelic drugs.
Je comprends ce que vous voulez dire. Voilà. En tant que représentant de la radio éphémère, je suis aussi.
I understand what you're saying. As a representative of FMR Radio, I am also an animatrice and a consommatrice, if I can say it like that. So I understand very well what you're saying. Thanks very much for answering my questions.
Je vais ajouter une question pour vous. Une information pour vous.
Oui, oui.
Mais je travaille dans un hôpital, dans la réduction de risque.
I would like to add a question if I can. It's maybe some information for you. I work in a hospital with harm reduction near Barcelona, and we also have a radio show like you, and we wanted to share the information.
peut-être les
On peut se donner les liens internet et on est sur Facebook.
We could share our website links and we're on Facebook too.
Okay.
So we'll give it all to you. Thanks very much.
Cocaïne, morphine, ecstasy,
méthadone,
tranquillium,
dormitum,
vodka,
champagne,
tabac,
cigarette,
sport,
Champions League,
doping, fashion, sexy, pornography, fast food,
wine, internet,
video games,
benzine, credit card,
money,
benefits, addiction.
Addict, addict, addict.
De Madame Keller, mais elle a été
oh, what a surprise Mindy has in store for us. She didn't stop with the interview with Mrs. Keller. She went to interview other people who are in assistance, like Mr. Elliot Albert, the international director responsible, well, basically the junkie director, or the junkie representative for the whole world. So a person that is very important and very active, but unfortunately, I can't give you much more information. So I'll let you listen.
Très importante et très active. Malheureusement, je ne peux pas vous donner plus d'informations. Donc, je vous laisserai écouter. Et ensuite, il y a un autre consommateur qui arrive.
And then there's another consommateur, and he came to this conference with a very precise question concerning the condition of drug users in prison.
Concernant la condition des personnes toxicomanes en milieu carcéral, il semblerait que ces personnes sont vivent dans des conditions.
Apparently, these people live in absolutely terrible conditions in countries like Quebec, in France, even in Switzerland, because I have the information that says that not only are drugs widely available for sale, but you also have to buy the injection material.
Information que non seulement le produit s'achète couramment, mais le matériel doit également se payer. Donc, on aiguise les aiguilles de nouveau.
So we sharpen needles again with sandpaper. We return to the Stone Age with all that that means in a community where no one gives a present to anyone.
Porte dans un milieu où personne ne fait de cadeau à personne. Daniel a eu la chance de...
So Daniel was lucky enough to interview J.F. Savary from the GREA, and I'm going to let you listen to what he has to say.
Je vous laisse écouter ce qu'il nous dit.
Voilà, bien le bonjour, Daniel Weber pour la radio FMR ici.
Hello, Daniel Weber for FMR Radio here in Basel at the European Conference for Harm Reduction.
Alors, Monsieur Savary, j'ai une question.
And I'm with Jean-Félix Savary. So, Mr. Savary, I've got a question for you, and it's about harm reduction in prison and about injection material. I met people from Quebec, from the association that publishes the magazine Injecteur and The Blender, who told us that in Canada, in prison, that injection material is rented, and that creates really serious health problems. And I want to know, how does it happen here? So we always say that here in Switzerland that we are ahead of other countries in harm reduction, and that we know how to treat drug problems to be able to end infections with injections, but this reality is unfortunately not the same in prison. In prison, there are a few establishments that have put programs into place thanks to some motivated professionals. For example, in Chandelon, in Geneva, where there is a needle exchange program, and there are also similar programs in a few Swiss-German prisons. There are even a couple of prisons in Swiss Germany that have a heroin prescription program. But in the large majority of prisons, the situation is catastrophical. And that, I think, it would be important for Switzerland, the country of the four-pillar system, to attack these problems.
S'attaquer à cette problématique. On sait que, en fait, il y a quand même un certain nombre de personnes qui passent à travers.
We know that there are a certain number of people that pass through the penitentiary system. We know that drug users are overrepresented because drug use is still criminalized. So it seems relatively irresponsible to not look into this dark spot of society.
De ne pas regarder dans cette tache sombre, on va dire, de la société. Parce qu'évidemment, on a réagi très fort quand il y avait.
Because we reacted very strongly when there was the Platzblitz, because it was a few steps away from the Bahnhofstrasse. We reacted very strongly with the Place du Molard in Geneva. That was an area for dealers. But what happens in prison, we tend to look less, and that's really unfortunate. Because if we're really responsible in matters of public health, we have to offer the same programs inside prisons as outside.
Donc, si j'ai bien compris,
so if I understand correctly, prisons are actually a factor for the transmission of different diseases, and that when a person is liberated, they are back in society, they can also contaminate other people.
Au sein de notre société, donc de contaminer d'autres personnes.
Exactement.
Exactly.
Exactement. Peut-être il faut bien voir que.
Maybe we have to see that we already had a problem accepting that people can use drugs in our society. And during the 90s, we put into place harm reduction. But today, we have even more problems accepting people who use drugs in prison.
On a accepter qu'on puisse même consommer en prison, parce que s'il y a des drogues.
And that if there are drugs in prison, it means that prohibition is really useless. Because if we're in a place that is very secure with prison guards and rooms that are searched regularly, and that even in a top security place, we can still have illegal products that circulate, and that means that prohibition is really a failure. And so it's maybe for this reason that it's more difficult to look at this problem.
And
we have a certain amount of people responsible for prisons who tell us that in my prison there aren't any drugs. And effectively, as soon as you accept to put programs into place, for example, needle exchange in prison, you accept that there are drugs in your establishment.
Une problématique qu'on devrait une fois.
Okay, but this is maybe a problem that we should look at more precisely because there is the question of the injectable drugs. That's where there is a problem of infection. But on the other hand, in Swiss prisons, we turn a blind eye to the use of other drugs, like cannabis, for example, that is used almost in order to pacify the prison. So I don't have an opinion on the subject, but it's a paradox, because in both cases, we turn a blind eye. On the one hand, we turn a blind eye on the use of illegal drugs, and we know that it will calm a certain amount of prisoners, that they will be less violent, and on the other hand, we turn a blind eye to the health problems that are linked with injectable drug use. So the word that comes easily to mind for me in this situation is hypocrisy. And effectively, it's often these closed places where we can't see inside. And the people on the inside, they know the problems, but in our society, we know the problems with the prison system. There are financial problems, an overpopulation, and today it's probably not the priority to say that there are drugs in prison in Switzerland. I think that the politicians would prefer to send other messages. And that's really too bad, because in the end, it's the drug users that will suffer. And maybe on a larger scale, society as a whole, because these are infectious diseases that don't stop at just one person.
Plus largement, effectivement, vu que c'est des maladies infectieuses qui ne s'arrêtent pas à une personne.
Mais derrière ce JF mystérieux, c'est Jean-Félix Savary du Gréa qui se cache. Personne indispensable, personne vraiment.
And hiding behind
honnête,
this GF, it's Jean-Félix Savary from the GREA. He's a person that's indispensable and honest and who says what's happening without beating around the bush. And we need people like this. And we hope that what he has to say will have an impact after this conference.
À la suite de ce congrès. Et le temps passe, le temps passe, le temps passe bien
so
trop
time
vite.
Is ticking away too fast,
voilà,
and here we are at the end of our show. I hope that you enjoyed listening to our broadcast and that there was information that was useful for you. And we're looking forward to finding you again tomorrow. Goodbye, and see you soon.
Et nous nous réjouissons de vous retrouver demain. Au revoir, à bientôt.
Aujourd'hui, moi...
So today, me, Jean-Poly Toxicoman, I was at the second European conference for harm reduction, and wow. I listened to people for hours, talking about things that they've never lived and that they can't understand, and pretending to find solutions, as if a mechanic was talking to me about baking and drug users had 3 minutes to speak. So is that harm reduction?